You've probably downloaded a plugin and found out that it's available in many different formats like VST, VST2, VST3, AU, AAX, 64-bit, 32-bit, and if you're new to music production, you're probably pretty confused as to which one you should install on your computer. In this video, I'm going to go over some of the differences between the formats and hopefully help you decide which one you need to install on your computer. I'm Zane. Welcome to Simple Green Tech, where I do weekly audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you conquer the tech and unleash your creativity. Now, if you've watched my channel for a while, you've probably seen me talk about plugins quite a bit. And one of the questions that comes up quite often is, which version of the plugin do I need to install? Well, what it can come down to can be based on the digital audio workstation or DAW that you're using, the operating system that you're using, and maybe even your computer. If you're a PC user on Windows 7 and up, and maybe even some older versions of Windows, and your DAW is 64-bit like FL Studio, Ableton Live 10 or higher, Cubase, Cakewalk, Waveform, Reaper, something along those lines, you're going to want to use a 64-bit VST3 and or VST2 plugin. Basically, if your DAW is 64-bit, you should be going with a 64-bit plugin. And at this time on PC, VST3 is the best option, as Steinberg have stopped support for VST2 and they're trying to get everyone moved over to the VST3 format. And I would say new VST3 format, but it's been around for over 10 years now, so it's not exactly new. Most manufacturers are offering their plugins in both VST2 and VST3 formats in 64-bit. So at this time, you can install whichever one you prefer, but VST3 may help your computer's performance a little bit. If you're enjoying this video so far and you're getting some value out of it, can you please give it a thumbs up? It really helps my channel out and I appreciate it so much. Now, if you're using a 32-bit operating system or just using a 32-bit DAW, you're going to want to install the 32-bit version of the VST plugin. Now, if you're unsure if your DAW is 32 or 64-bit, head over to the manufacturer's website and you should be able to find out from there. Now, if you're on a 64-bit PC, you should really be using a 64-bit DAW as it's going to allow you to use more of your system's RAM and it will give you better performance. So I just talked about VST2 and VST3s. Now let's look at the AAX format. Basically, if you're using Pro Tools as your digital audio workstation and you're on a Mac or a PC, use the AAX version of your plugin. You might also want to install the VST version in case you have a second DAW on your computer. I've noticed that Pro Tools users often have a second or third DAW installed on their computer, so be sure to install the AAX and the VST version of the plugin so you can use it in whatever DAW you're using. Now, if you're a Mac user and you're using any other digital audio workstation that's not Pro Tools, you can use the AU format. And this is basically like the VST format, but it's exclusive to Mac. I think most DAWs on Mac allow you to use AU and VST, so you can choose whichever one you prefer. And I'm not a Mac user, so I don't know if there's a big benefit to using AU over VST. But one thing to keep in mind, if you plan on collabing with anyone who uses a Windows computer, you may want to use VSTs, as that will allow them to use the same plugins that you do when you're sharing projects. Now, there is an older plugin format that may pop up every now and then, and it is Rtaz or Rtaz. And Rtaz used to be the exclusive Pro Tools format before they went with AAX. So unless you're using a very old version of Pro Tools, I think version 9 and under, you don't need to worry about Rtaz. If you want to check out some of the best free DAWs that are available, click up here or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching for Simple Green Tech. I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.